You are looking at the city of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and this will be the final scene on my N-scale layout. I'm going to build the city and the passenger station and the background hill, which will be part of this video. So hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. It's going to be a lot of cool ideas, and I need your help. So what I'm going to work on is the background mountain. It's pretty boring, actually. Can get away with making it as flat as possible. But how? This is the Amtrak passenger tracks. And the former tower is now for the police. Okay, so I have 1-inch thick insulation. Yes, there is like plastic sheeting on the other side, which we'll strip off later. But I just took a felt pen and traced what I thought would be a good mountain. Then I took an X-Acto blade. Probably be better if I used a larger blade, because it didn't cut all the way through, and it kind of made me have a struggle to get this. Got it. Okay. And then peel it off that plastic sheet on the other side. So I got some of it, and actually I put it on top so I knew how to make the additional piece which height I needed so it matched. And I cut that out with the X-Acto blade. There's foam cutting tools you can use. Snap! Much better. Okay, so you see what I mean? Blends perfectly because I matched their height. This section of the layout is, I think it's 3 feet wide, but it's 8 feet long. And then using that foam, I made the retaining wall, that concrete retaining wall. Remember what I'm talking about? This back here? I'm doing my own version because there's a highway in front of it that I'm not going to do. So nothing has to be exact. Just do your interpretations. And I wanted a little bit of depth, so I made one section a little bit wider with an additional piece of foam. And now we get how it's going to look. All right, what's next? All right, my first mistake was I hate this color green. It's cheap paint, though. So it's just going to work as a base color. Whatever. That's the thing. You're going to make mistakes. You could just go over them with more of an olive drab. Just kind of tone it down or mute the color a little bit. The hardboard. Home Depot 4x8 sheet. I had them cut it into a 2-foot by 8-foot. And I had to cut it one of the other pieces because the total length of the layout is going to be like 12 feet. And I rolled on some paint. Not completely sold on this color. It's blue with gray because honestly where I live, it's more gray than blue. Plus it's going to be a nighttime scene. I did spill the paint, so I just took the roller and just rolled with it. All right. So once it dried, now I don't have to do the whole thing because some of the layout where it's going to attach won't be visible. So that's where we're at regarding this. So we have the background and we're starting to work on the hill. Okay, what's next? All right, so the next thing I did is I got some liquid nails for projects. I'm going to glue the two pieces together. Now, eventually, I'm going to glue it to the layout itself. I just need this to stay together. I filled in this gap because this area that's still pink is going to be covered with another piece, so you're not going to see it anyway. I'm a big fan of liquid nails, but you do have to give it time to dry. A lot of times, I think 24 hours is pretty good, depending on your humidity. I got a big area to cover. Smooth it out. I like liquid nails better. I tried hot glue, not a fan. So now I got my foam all glued together. It looks better now that I muted that green with more of an olive. Okay, here's where I want your thoughts. Leave it in the comments. I'm using the Woodland Scenics clump foliage and also foliage clusters. Now you can make your own. If you watch one of my layouts from a few years back, I made my own with a blender, with white foam, and with green paint and glue. And it worked out good. Sometimes you just don't feel like doing that. You want to go to the hobby store. You can mix medium green with dark green. Now this, it falls apart easily. Ah, there's pros and cons to that. That's what I wanted to talk about in this video. So I used this Eileen's tacky glue. I thought it was the same as Elmer's white glue, but maybe stronger. That was what I was hoping. I thought this would all be perfect. This is going to be the top rim of my background. This is only, I think, a half inch thick foam. I thought I want that full mountain look, but I don't want, you know, it being a foot wide or 6 inches wide. I want to see if I can get this as narrow as possible. It's not going to be the big focal point for your eyes, but I want some depth other than just a photo backdrop. And then if I just press these foliage clusters into this non-diluted white glue, I'll leave comments if you think, okay, I see where you screwed up. Figured I'll do this row first. And I don't want them too big. Just the further things are away, the smaller you want to make them. Ah, there's your tip for the day. All right. So what do you think so far? So far, so good, right? All right. So when that was dry, I laid it flat. And then I just poured all this white glue on, and I used a foam brush. And I figured, I mean, this does feel tackier than Elmer's white glue. It's not diluted. Once again, it's not diluted. I thought, okay, I want this stuff to stick on here. Nothing's going to fall off of this. I'll use it directly from the bottle, and it'll hold, no issues. And that was what I thought. So I cover the whole upper part. I'm gonna do the upper part first. And then I just kind of sprinkled this mix of that's a hard word to say for me. Foliage clusters and the clump foliage. Kind of press it down with the back of my hand. Now, do you see what could possibly go wrong? Since there was gaps, I used like a similar color, like fine turf, to fill in some of the gaps. Now, yes, I could have painted the background, I'm sorry, the base color brown. That way, if it showed through, it looked just more like the earth. But it's looking good, right? And that concrete wall, that's just simple acrylics that I painted with the foam brush. A couple of different colors, just streaked it with white, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of rust, a little bit of brown. It looks like aged concrete. All right, so here we go. Well, that's all drying. I decided to make some rock molds. Nothing out of the ordinary. I've been making these things for 20 years. It's awesome. Very simple. If you haven't tried this, try this. This stuff's so fun. You got kids, do this with the kids. Always add the plaster to the water. I use the Will and Scenic mixing bowls. They're easy to clean up. I did a video on that. Everything that I use, you can find in pretty much any hobby store. Even at Michael's or Hobby Lobby or whatever you have, good craft stores. Nothing out of the ordinary. And yes, you can tint the plaster before you put in the mold if you want to do so. Once they're dry, give them time to dry. Don't rush it. Pop them out. If they break, they break. So what? More liquid nails. I'm just going to glue random pieces in. And then I thought, oh, man, I'm still seeing some bare spots. And I thought a good idea would just be to use bigger clumps, like the bigger foliage clusters, and add some real dimension by putting bigger pieces in. I did dilute that glue on the last part. Okay, so here, you know what? If you feel you don't like a color, go over it. That's what I decided to do. I decided, you know what? This is going to be way more brown because there's going to be more rocks showing. So let me just change that from green to brown. I'm going to add some water. I'm going to dilute the acrylic paint. Just simple 50 cent to a dollar paint. Nothing complicated. I added some darker color in the crevices where the sun don't shine. Where I think it would be a little darker. Kind of make the rocks stand out with like more of like a shadow effect. And dilute it. Heck, I even added some orange. And you're thinking, wait, orange? Yes, go take a look at rocks. You'll see such variety of colors. And then I went back over a lot of that stuff with the tan again. Just make sure it all blended nice together. So few different colors gives it a nice look. All right, you want to have some fun? Let's make some polyfiber trees. This is fun. We've done this to layouts in the past. Polyfiber, so fun to work with. Spread it so it's very thin like that. Okay. Make a bunch. Make a whole bunch. Different sizes too. And then mix. You can use matte medium if you have it. I didn't have it, so I used a mix of white glue and water. Stir it up. Put on some gloves. Trust me, you don't want green fingers. All right, so you dip a polyfiber ball in that water glue mix, and then you get a pan of the scenery material, Woodland Scenic, Scenic Express, wherever you want to make it, your polyfiber trees, little puff balls. You can mix different colors. All right. So when they're mostly dry, not 100% dry, when they're mostly dry, I used more of this white glue. I did dilute it. As you can see, it's running now. That's the trick. See, I think what happened all along was I wasn't diluting the glue. And the water is really what kind of bonds it all together. You know, having your material like very like wet instead of just trying to go straight white glue. I'll show you what happened when this is all said and done. So you still have moisture in the polyfiber, and that's going to bond all of this together. Eventually the water dries. Now, I have a dehumidifier going in my downstairs. Try to keep it as dry as possible. I use different colors and different sizes and a mix of everything. But guess what happened? Look, this is what I want to talk about in this video. So often those little clusters, they would fall off. I mean, every day I was cleaning this up and I felt like, oh man, I screwed up this video. And I didn't know how to fix it. And, you know, I asked different people and they said, try spraying it with cheap hairspray. I'm like, all right, I'll give it a shot. This was dollar store. I think it was White Rain, cheap hairspray. I was like, I'm desperate because this stuff was falling off every single day because it wasn't diluted. The glue was not diluted. It did not bond it all together. And I thought, please don't let me screw this up. See how it would just fall off? But once the hairspray took hold, flawless. Nothing falls off anymore. What do you think? Layout's coming along pretty good. If I can do this, you guys can do this. I'm not a genius. Ask anyone that knows me. I'm not an artist. Trust me. I just figured out just how to fix mistakes. Look, come on, man. This is foam. This is foam and it looks good. And it's only an inch thick. And I don't need to have this big background that takes up all this space, especially because I'm working in N scale. And it's all stuff you can get at every hobby store. And man, does that look good? I mean, of course, the foreground scenery, when I start building more foreground scenery, it's going to take your eye away from this. But if you do want to look closely at it, it looks good. If I can do this, you can do this. So go to my YouTube channel, subscribe, go to the playlist about like scenery and layout building. You guys can do this. Thanks for watching. Go check out my older videos. I've got about 400. So take the whole weekend off and watch them all. If you want to interact with me on Patreon, we could do Zoom calls. Check that out too. If you just want to support the channel, there's always a PayPal link. I appreciate it. Daughter's starting to finish her senior, start her senior year, and she wants to drive. So help me.